Okay students, in our previous class already we have completed two activities. In that first activity we have discussed about the test for presence of starch, and one more activity we have tested whether sunlight is necessary for the process of photosynthesis or not. So now children, we will go for our another activity, that is activity number 6. So in this activity we will test whether chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis or not. So see children, take out page number 9 and look at activity number 6. To test whether chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis, materials needed: A. Coleus plant, a plant with green and non-green areas on leaves, spirit, water, iodine, container, beaker and a plate. So we need a coleus plant. Coleus plant means, the leaves have two colors. Some portion of the leaf will be green in color and other portion will be different, like yellow, purple, brown. You can see in your school surrounding, some plants will have such two types of colors for its leaves. So such type of plants we call it as coleus plant. So we have to take coleus plant and spirit, water, iodine, containers, beaker and one plate. So now, keep the coleus plant in sunlight. Select a leaf which is partially green. So that plant we have to bring it and keep it in the sunlight. Then out of that, take one leaf which is having a green color, on which the color green, on which color green is very less. You should choose the leaf in such a way that that leaf should have green color in very less quantity. Other color can be more, but green color quantity should be very less. Carry out steps 2, 3 and 4 as in activity 4 on this coleus leaf. Observe what happens. So actually in our activity 4 stage, test for iodine, starch, presence of starch, we did know what we did in that second, third and fourth steps. First we took a leaf, we have boiled it in the hot water. After boiling it in the hot water, we took the same leaf and boiled it in the spirit. After boiling it in the spirit, we took the leaf and immersed it, put it in the cold water, and then we removed the leaf and put it place it on one plate. And after placing it on the plate, we took iodine solution and added 1 by 1 drop on it. Yes or no? Next, so we should repeat this process for this leaf also. Means you should boil it in water first, then boil it in the spirit, then dip it in the cold water, then place it on a plate. After that, what we should do, see children. So we should, after that we should add iodine solution to that. Next, what we observe, see, if you look at the pictures. So here this part of the leaf is green color, this is some other. So if you look at your textbook, so this part is green. So that is why it is not able to make its food. So by this experiment, we can say that chlorophyll is very essential for the preparation of food in the process of photosynthesis by plants. Next, how do non-leafy plants or non-green plants make food? So children, already we have discussed in your previous classes that there are some plants which are non-green, which are not having the green leaves. And there are also some plants which do not have leaves like cactus. So how do they prepare food? Mushroom, it also doesn't have any leaves. So how do they prepare their food? See, let us see. We know that plants with green leaves make food. We also know that leaves must contain chlorophyll in order to make food. In cactus plant, leaves are modified into thorns. Then which part of this plant makes food? The food is prepared in its thick green stems. So see children, we know that plants which are having green leaves can make their own food. Why? Because there is a substance called chlorophyll which is present on the leaf, and it will help the leaf to prepare food in the presence of sunlight. So cactus plant leaves. Can you see leaves on a cactus plant? No, you can see thick stem. And for that you can see thorns. Thorns means pointed, sharp pointed structures you can see. So that point, that thorns will act as a leaf for a cactus plant. So then in cactus plant, which part will make food? Green. Leaves are not there, which will make green stem, that thick fleshy stem which is there in cactus plant. No, that portion will prepare food for the cactus plant. Have you seen mushrooms growing on moist wood? So when wood continuously gets wet, you can see soft structure. Or else in some places where there is really wet, you can see mushrooms, white color mushrooms growing on it, right? So, but they are not green in color. How they prepare their food? See, they do not contain chlorophyll. They are not having green color. So chlorophyll is not present. How they can prepare food? To prepare food, chlorophyll is essential. So there is no chlorophyll. How they will prepare food? If they won't prepare food, can they survive? No, but they are surviving. How they are able to survive without making food? See here. They absorb nutrients from the dead and decaying plants and animals. So they get their food from the dead and decaying. Decaying means after any animal or any plant is dead, it decomposes, it mixes with the soil. No? From that dead and decaying matter, the mushrooms, non-green plants, absorb nutrients and minerals from dead and decaying plants. Next, see here, you can see cactus, croton, mushroom. So the leaves of some species of croton. So here you can see crotons. All the leaves are green in color, children. No, these are in different colors, and it is a shrub, children. It is not a tree. It is a shrub. Shrub means small plant. And it is red in color. It is which in color? It is red in color. The red pigment in the leaves hide the green color of chlorophyll. The red portion of the leaf in the croton plants, it has chlorophyll. Inside the red leaf, you can see chlorophyll, which is green in color. Though the green color is less, the presence of chlorophyll in croton leaves allows photosynthesis to take place. So when you observe, you can see brown color part more. Green color part will be less, even though the green portion is less, chlorophyll which is present in the green part, it will help the plant to prepare its food with the help of the sunlight. Leaves of cactus turn into thorns. So cactus plants do not have leaves. So leaves turn into thorns. But its stem is green. Its stem is green in color. Thick stem you can see. plants. Herbivores, see. See here, children, you can see the cycle. So, sun's energy is absorbed by the plants. Plants are eaten by animals and human beings. So, this is how energy flows from one to another in the earth. So, it is better for us, it is very good for our health if we eat leafy vegetables more. Herbivores eat plants or plant products. So, children, there are three types of animals. Herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Already we have learned about them in your class 3. So, herbivores, they eat only plants. Carnivores, they eat only animals. Means they are dependent on other animals. Omnivores, they eat both plants and animals. So, herbivores eat plants or plant products. They obtain energy from the plants directly. So, herbivores are having food from the plant. So, they are getting the energy from the plant directly. When omnivores and carnivores eat herbivores, so omnivores and carnivores, they eat herbivores, no? So from the herbivores, this omnivores and carnivores are getting the sun's energy. Energy does flow from one main source into the plants and then into animals. So the sun's energy, first it will, who is absorbing the sun's energy? Plants. And plants are eaten by herbivores, means humans, animals, some animals.